Oh, g'day, Joey here. Back to Mel Bay's modern guitar method, grade 3. And this is part 12 of me going through the grade 3 book, which I'm really enjoying. And if anyone's following along with me, hope you're enjoying it too. Apologies that I don't get to it as often as I'd like. I really love going through it. And every time I start a new exercise or a new Mel Bay arrangement, I always enjoy it and I always learn a lot. I always feel I get a lot out of it. So persevere with it. I think it's worth it. So today we have a classical composition that Mel Bay has arranged for guitar. He's done a fantastic job on this too. So this is called Polish Dance. I've got the title up on the screen there. Polish Dance, also known as, and this might be the original name from the Polish composer, Kujawiak in A minor. So it's in A minor. The composer is Henryk Wieniawski. I think, hopefully that's close to the correct pronunciation. He is Polish, by Mel Bay. You can see the year there, 1853. And so Mel Bay does a terrific job reducing it all from 88 key piano composition to something we can do on the guitar. In the way he's arranged it, he gets us to do different little things that we can get a lot out of in playing it. So that's why, even if you only practice 4 bars or 8 bars at a time, you'll still get a lot out of this. The composition, I've reduced it, by the way, it's very long in the book. I've reduced it to just 2 pairs of 8 bars that are repeated, and then a final 5 bars that takes us to the ending that's in the book, which is a good ending too, by the way. So I'll do the first 8 bars and then talk a tiny bit of what we've just done. I'll do the next 8 bars, talk a tiny bit, and then I'll finish it off, yeah? So the tab's up, let's just do a playthrough. And we start off with this interesting chord here on the third fret. F, B, D, A. Yep, I'll talk about that when we've done it. Okay, first playthrough. In 3/4 time. 1, 2, 3. So how's that a way to end those 8 bars? So let's quickly talk about this chord, funny chord, F, B, D, A. I mean, if you're a songwriter and you started a song with a chord like that, you'd be pretty pleased with yourself, I reckon. Fantastic chord. So it's very similar to an F diminished, but by keeping the A natural, you notice how you get a much sweeter sound, yeah? So I have 3 ways to describe that chord or to give it a name. Firstly, imagine this A minor 7 triad. And if we go up a step. Yeah. And then if we add the F bass, we're basically doing a B minor 7 over F. F being the flattened fifth or the diminished fifth. Those 4 notes are identical to the notes in this chord. That's called a B minor 7 with a flat fifth. You'd write the chord out like that, B minor 7, flat fifth. Another way to describe the chord is imagine, so we're back here, the F, D and A, they're notes in a D minor with an F bass, add the B note, so you effectively create a D minor 6 over F. And the third way to describe it is we've got the F, the A and the D. Could be called an F6. Add that B note, which is a flattened fifth or diminished fifth. So you end up with an F6 flat fifth. And that's why the chord is, you know, well, as we just said, the chord is similar to an F diminished chord because you have the sixth and the flat and fifth. But we keep the A natural in it. Okay, that's that opening chord. I'll just mention one other little thing, nice thing about that those opening eight bars. Notice how we end up doing four C chords. You in that second bar, you go. So that's two different C triads, even though we keep our fingers in the same spot. Then we finish the first four bars with this C triad. By the way, he says in the book to do this fingering. So you go. I'm guessing he says to do that fingering so that you quickly go from having your little pinky on the A note to doing the C triad. Now, the next four bars we end up with up here on this C chord, but those three notes of the C chord are identical to those three notes. So the key point about Mel Bay getting us to go up here is to get that high C note. If you can imagine the pianist going, hitting that high C, we're doing the same thing. We go up the fretboard predominantly to make sure we get that high C, so we get a different sound to just, different sound, nicer sound. Let's do the next eight bars. Let's go. This is what I call the somber section with this low, E. So that's how that somber section ends. First four bars we end on the A minor. Second four bars we end on the E. Right? And that's repeated. I'll just mention quickly that first chord we play. It's like an E7, except we've got a flattened ninth there. The F natural is a flattened ninth, yeah? Flat ninth, or add flat nine. And then you do the E7. Oh, this is nice. D minor. Then D minor in this position. Yeah. Yeah. Nice. Very nice. Final four bars. And so this section is just intended to finish the whole piece. Yes, it does end on this unusual chord, A, F sharp, C, E, A. So if we were just to do C, E, A, that's straight out A minor. Then we have this F sharp, so it basically becomes an A minor 6. It's unresolved. It sort of has a bit of shock value. It's a big surprise. And you're wondering, it leaves you wondering, well, why is there anything like that? Because, we did one set of eight bars was sort of cheerful and bright, then another set of eight bars was sort of somber, and then we sort of have this quiet bit, and then we end with this unusual chord, yeah? I can't answer why it ends like that. The musical theorists out there will have a good answer, I'm sure. But anyway, beautiful, fun piece to play on guitar. As I say, grab four or eight bars and just play around with it. Have a good practice with it. I really enjoyed learning this. I hope you enjoyed this as well. Okay, see you next time. Bye-bye.